Hi everybody, welcome to NuttX channel. Today I'll explain how to use Init Script in the NuttX. Using it, we can run some commands or application before the NuttX shell to start up. The Init Script support in the NuttX use the ROM file system, so we need to install the genromfs to create the ROM image. So let's get started. Open the Linux terminal. Enter inside NuttX space, NuttX. Execute, make this clean to clear previous configuration. Now we need to install the genromfs. So apt get install genromfs. The genromfs was installed correctly. Now we can follow with the configuration to get support to init script on the NuttX. First, we need to configure the STM32F4 discovery board. Execute tools configure.sh STM32F4 discovery/NSH. We need to run make menu config to select the options to enable the init script in the NuttX. So make menu config. We need to go to build setup, build roles platform, and change to Linux. Exit. Go to device drivers, enable run disk support, exit, go to file systems, enable ROMFS file system, exit, go to application configuration, NSH library, go to scripting support, enable support ROMFS startup script, and finally go to ROMFS header location and change it to architecture specific ROM path. We can exit again, and finally exit and save. The next step is to create the RCS template. So we need to go to configs, STM32F4 discover, include, and we will create the lowercase rc, uppercase s, dot template. In this file, we will put the init script commands. Okay, now we can run the command to create the ROMFS image. To do that, we need to run the command in the tools directory. So we need to return 1, 2, 1, 2, 3 directories and tools mk ROMFS image.sh. Also, we need to pass the root directory, so we can return 3 directories as well. But if we run this command, it will fail because we didn't enable the FAT file system. We don't want to use the FAT file system. So, as you can see, it failed. We need to pass no FAT support. So it creates an image without using FAT. If we run ls again, we can see it create an NSH runfs image.h header file with the content of the runfs. So we can return to root directory and just execute make to compile the source code. The source code was compiled. Now I will explain how to connect the USB serial adapter in the STM32F4 discovery board. Okay, first connect the GND, the black wire, to STM32F4 discovery board GND pin. Connect the receiver, the green wire here, to PA2, to this pin, PA2. You need to connect under the board. And finally connect the transmitter pin, the brown wire, to PA3. Here, also under the board. And it is done. Now we can flash the firmware inside the board. So, execute. Open OCD to flash the firmware. Okay, it was flashed. Let you plug the USB serial adapter and see if the TTY USB 0 was detected. Okay, it was detected. Now we can execute minicom and reset the board. As you can see, it is running the init script. Okay, it worked fine. We can also put your application to be called in the init script. It is very useful to run your application before the NSH shell starts. So, basically, that is it. I hope you had enjoyed this video. If you are not subscribed to NuttX channel, please subscribe. See you in the next video. Bye bye.